I was a practicing midwife in a small town in Oregon for 23 years. I've known for a very long time that I wanted to work for MSF. So I actually retired from my private practice in order to work with MSF. I also knew that I wanted to work in French-speaking Africa. I had some background in French from college, but that was a very long time ago. So about 3 years ago, I started studying French on my own. I read Harry Potter in French. I read all sorts of children's books. I listened to French tapes in order to prepare. There's a great need for French-speaking midwives in Africa. And I wanted to be able to have the opportunity to work in Francophone Africa. I had had some experience working in Africa, doing some training, some teaching of midwifery skills, as well as some community education projects. That was extremely satisfying work, but my issue has always been with many NGOs is that the ethics of the organizations are not necessarily aligned with what I feel is appropriate for international work. So along with a lot of other people who join MSF, I was very impressed with MSF's philosophy of witnessing, témoignage. It's important to MSF that people speak of what they see and to be as honest and forthright about the work that MSF does. I think that that's extremely important in all work, especially in international work. But MSF has the principles that I agree with, and that's why I was attracted to MSF, as well as an extremely good international reputation. It's a definitely a challenge to work for MSF. It's necessary often to go to the field for months at a time. I knew that I was willing to make that kind of commitment, but it also meant asking my family to make that commitment as well. I am married. I have two married children, and I have now two grandchildren. It means that my family needs to provide me with support that I need when I'm gone, but also it means that I'm not around to be the mother for the family. That's difficult. My daughter actually had her baby while I was gone, and I came back from Cote d'Ivoire and she had already delivered, even though the plan had been for me to be here when she had her baby. It's definitely a sacrifice, and it requires a family who is understanding and also committed to the idea of international work, even though they might personally not go.